Hello everyone, it's Alireza from Noble Realm Support here. Merry Christmas to you all from Noble Realm team. I wish you a very great year. In today's video, I want to explain the entire installation progress of Noble Realm. I have seen many people having problems installing the ROM, and they mostly face boot loops because of the very small things they do not know of. I have to note here that Noble ROM is only made for Exynos variants, so don't make the mistake of flashing it on other devices. It's not compatible with the Snapdragon model. So now, let's get things started. Okay, first of all, you need to make sure that you are coming from the latest stock Android 10 firmware by Samsung before flashing Noble ROM. Many users directly flash Noble ROM on Android Pie or Oreo and face boot loops. You can download the latest stock firmware for your device from these websites. They are also written in the description. Make sure you download it based on your country CSC. For users using Korean variants with these models, keep in mind that Noble ROM doesn't have dual SIM patch. That means it won't convert single SIM into dual SIM. If you want to use your device as dual SIM, you first have to convert single SIM into dual SIM. There are videos for that on YouTube. And for those who are using N variants with dual SIM, you don't have to worry as your phone is converted already. So it will also continue to work as usual in Noble ROM. Now make sure that you have downloaded all the files needed, including the ROM itself and TWRP. Also make sure to use the TWRP version recommended by Alexis so you won't run into issues installing the ROM. Recommended TWRP version for Noble ROM is 3.3.1.x. The links are available in our description for all the devices that are supported by Noble ROM. Now we need to install TWRP on the phone. In order to do that, we need to enable OEM unlock in developer options. For enabling developer options, we have to head into settings, about phone, software information, and tap on build number for 7 times. And now the developer mode is turned on. Now go back to the main menu and find developer options. Tap on it. Now we have to enable OEM unlock option. Keep in mind that enabling OEM unlock option will delete all the data inside your phone, so make sure to back up your data before doing it. I have enabled OEM unlock already, so I will just skip this part. Now that you have enabled OEM unlock option, when the phone boots after the factory reset, we have to turn off the phone and go into download mode. There are many ways to go into download mode. I just connect one side of the cable to my PC, and I have to connect the other side into my phone. For going into download mode, I have to press and hold volume down button and Bixby button, and then connect my cable into my phone. And as you can see, the download mode appears. Volume up for going into this mode. Now, we have to switch into the PC. Okay, in here, I have to open the Odin application. I have to place a TWRP file into AP section of the TWRP, then go into the options and turn off auto reboot. Now, start flashing TWRP. When flashing TWRP, show pass, Now, we have to switch again to our phone. Okay. I have to restart the phone and boot into TWRP. For doing that, the thing I'm going to do is to hold the power button and volume down at the same time for 7 seconds as it's written here. And then immediately before the phone logo just shows up, I have to press and hold the power button, Bixby button, and volume up to go into download mode. So I'm gonna do it right now. Now the phone restarted before it phone logo shows. I have to. Yes, and TWRP shows up. So here we just have to swipe to pass the first screen, nothing very important. Then we need to go inside the wipe section, inside the format data. We are going to type yes in here and done. When the format data finished, go back one step inside the advanced wipe. Now, tick these options: Dalvik, cache, system, vendor, data. Internal is optional. We have already wiped it, so it's not really needed, but as I don't have anything inside of it, I just wipe it. And preload is not something very important. You can wipe it or not. It depends on you. Not very important thing. And now we're gonna swipe. After this thing is done, go back inside the main menu, going to reboot and reboot to recovery and swipe and let the phone reboot into the TWRP again. Okay, now that the phone rebooted into TWRP again, back up the EFS and baseband as it's so important. To do so, go inside the backup menu here and tick the EFS and also baseband to backup. I have already done it, and so I just skip this part. We have to go into install section, go wherever you have copied the NovelROM zip file and select zip file, swipe.
So before you are wondering why we have two versions of the zip, it's because the installation bug happening on the N variant of the phones. So if you have the Korean model of the S9, S9 Plus or Note 9, please use the N variant zip for the installation. If you have the F variant, aka the international version of the S9, S9 Plus or Note 9, you can use the normal or the N variant version.
Okay, here you can see the change log of each NovelROM versions. We have to check the agree box in here, go to the next step, clean install, and here we have to choose the CSC. I go with the DBT. You can choose based on the country you are living in. And next, okay, here we have three options. Okay, no deep load. We recommend this option for starters, but be aware that choosing this option will delete the USSD code function in the ROM, Alex's deep load, functions like Search App Finder, VPN support, Edge panel, USSD code, AR zone, Bixby, and your stuff are the main things being deleted from the ROM by choosing this option. And finally, advanced deep load. Here you can almost make your own ROM and choose unnecessary stuff to get rid of. Also, 90% of the apps in advanced deep load can be installed via Play Store or Galaxy Store. Here I go with advanced deep load so you can see which options we have in here. I just deployed based on my needs, so please don't deploy stuff based on what I'm doing in here. Only deploy what you don't really need yourself, as people's preferences and tastes are different. I deploy the link to Windows and our cover. Just some Samsung apps you can delete in here. I go with the extra Samsung installer and Samsung AR apps. Bixby apps, I just skip this part and build prop tweaks. Here, increase image quality is for increasing a picture quality in gallery. Multi-user gives you the ability to make different user space when you want to give your phone to somebody else, so they won't have access to your personal files. Disabling SPCM app killer allows the apps to stay longer in the background and memory, but be aware that disabling this feature leads to more battery drain. I choose these two and next. Here we can see the CSC features which you have to choose based on your own needs. All the options have descriptions and their functions are clear to understand. Just keep in mind that if the ROM booted, but some of the functions you have selected do not exist in the ROM, just try flashing with another CSC, as some CSCs are bugged. The best working CSCs I have tried are Vietnam and also Germany. I just choose based on my needs in here and next. Okay. We have the option to remap the Bixby button now for one of the following commands. I like take screenshot. It's really my favorite. Now next. Okay. Here we have some add-ons. As you can see, for the kernel, it's a personal preference. Kernel files are included in Noble ROM zip file. You can extract them, flash, try, and pick your own favorite. So you don't have to flash the whole ROM when you want to change the kernel. By the way, updated version of the Noble kernel is uploaded in our Telegram channel and also Mustafa GitHub profile if you want. Here, I will just skip the options that are clear to understand. The GoodLock Launcher mod installs a modded version for those who cannot access official GoodLock in their countries. Kernel Manager app's name is ThunderTweak based on HWTweaks, and it allows you to change to some kernel settings using this app. If you're not really into playing with your phone and its settings, just skip this part. But I really recommend trying it. APK file is also available in our Telegram group and Mustafa's GitHub profile again. Always on display is a very important thing to note in here. If you choose OneUI 3.1 AOD, everything is fine unless you update it. When you update it, it will be always show that the phone is charging even though it's not. With OneUI 4 AOD, you will get that charging bug too, but it also breaks the clock style in lock screen. Boot animation options are clear. I will just select the Noble boot animation so you can see how it looks like. I bet you have seen S21 boot animation in YouTube or somewhere else for many times. Phone and emojis are, again, something personal preference. So now we have to choose next and wait for the ROM to get installed. As you can see, and it's written here, the ROM installation will take up to 2 or 3 minutes at most. Now that the installation finished successfully, we can tap yes and we have to tap on reboot the system, do not install. The first boot will take up to 15 minutes. Those coming from stock ROM may also need to flash the ROM twice to get the ROM working. Okay, now the RAM is ready. Okay, enjoy, guys. I tried to explain everything necessary in this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Peace out.